update there. Now to this, an IMPD officer accused of punching a 17-year-old student is now facing criminal charges. Marion County Prosecutor Terry Curry just made that announcement this afternoon, and Kelly Rinke is explaining how prosecutors came to that decision. Kelly.
It's been more than 3 weeks since that incident at Shortridge High School, and now prosecutor Terry Curry believes Officer Lawson hit a student without a legitimate concern for self-defense. This video posted on Facebook shows a heated exchange between a woman and police officers at Shortridge High School. Then you can see an IMPD officer hit a 17-year-old when the student steps in the way. That officer is Robert Lawson. Prosecutors say he told them he hit the teen because he was afraid the teen was going to hit him.
The threshold question for us was whether or not Officer Lawson was acting in self-defense. In other words, did he have a reasonable fear that justified his actions?
After reviewing the video and talking to multiple witnesses from Shortridge High School, prosecutors decided to charge Lawson with battery. But that's not all. Prosecutor Terry Curry says Officer Lawson signed documents stating he threw an open hand palm strike.
The version of facts that were outlined in that report are not consistent with the video or the witness statements that we received.
Chief Trial Deputy Ryan Mears claims Officer Lawson reported that another officer saw the student swing his fist at him first. Prosecutors say the other officer denied making that statement. So prosecutors have also charged Officer Lawson with obstruction of justice and false informing.
Everyone's going to be treated fairly, and that we're going to assess everyone based on their conduct.
IMPD Chief Brian Roach says Officer Lawson has been placed on suspension without pay, and the recommendation is that he should be fired. Prosecutors believe he turned himself in this afternoon. The superintendent of IPS says she is supportive of the decision made by Prosecutor Curry, and she says they will continue to work to make sure all students are provided a safe learning environment. Reporting on the near north side, I'm Kelly Rinke, Fox 59 News.